Okay, this is Sherman with Highland Park Lapidary, and I'm going to show you how to change a start capacitor on a motor. Now, I'll be doing this with a high-speed sphere machine, but the same principle applies to any motor that goes on any of the machines. There's two capacitors in a motor that we sell. We use only dual capacitor motors for the most part. There's a start capacitor and a run capacitor. Start capacitor gives the motor torque. It's what's necessary for getting going. So if you have a motor that you turn it on, it's like, but then you spin it by hand, it goes zoom, starts and starts running, that's a bad start capacitor. Super easy to replace. Run capacitor affects the overall performance and energy efficiency of the motor. Usually they're harder to know that there's a run capacitor, but they usually hardly ever go out. Start capacitor tends to be the capacitor that if you do have one not working, it will be that capacitor. So we're gonna go and we're gonna change it. Now right off the bat, I don't know in this machine which is the start capacitor, so my first tip is to find out which one's the start capacitor. So I'll need a Phillips screwdriver to do that. Phillips screwdriver, and I'm going to start with the top one because it's easy. Undo these screws, and my second screw. These just have a little rubber gasket on there, and you'll see underneath there, the capacitor is kind of wrapped in some foam, and I'm going to take this apart. I'm going to slip this off, and this says motor starting capacitor. So lo and behold, that's my start capacitor, and this one is a 64 microfarad. That little U and the F means microfarad, and this is a start capacitor. So to replace this, there's just two wires. These are the two wires on the thing. Now. Usually, if you got a bad start capacitor, you're not going to have any charge on it, but capacitor is like a battery, so you do want to be aware that it does hold a charge or can hold a charge. So I'm just going to go grab a start capacitor, show you the crimp connections. Now, by the way, when you go to wire this up, it doesn't matter which wire goes to which terminal. There's not a specificity for a start capacitor, so all you're doing is you're going to do two crimp connectors with that capacitor, and you're going to be good to go. I need a tool for crimping, so you'll need some kind of tool that's going to crimp your connection, and you're going to need a tool that can strip your wire. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to remove the old capacitor, put a new capacitor on, crimp it, and then your installation's done. So the first thing I'm going to do is just cut this old one off of here, and I try to cut it back as close as to the terminal as possible. So I've cut that. That's the old capacitor. I've removed it. Then what I'm going to do is with a wire stripper, I prefer a wire stripper, then I'm going to strip the wire back, not super far, just enough that I'm going to expose some wire here. And then I want to cut it off nice and crisp because there's a couple of little stragglers there. And then I'm going to twist this a little bit so there's no real stragglers there. I got my two wires now, and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to take my new capacitor and I'm going to put two wires together, and I'm not twisting them per se because I'm going to use these little butt connectors, and I'm going to put that in together. So now I have that little connector there. I don't know if you can see that good, but that connector just slips on those two wires. Then I'm going to use my crimper and I'm going to put that right here, and I'm going to go. And I want to make sure that's good and crimped. Then I'm going to pull on it. I really want to pull on it, make sure that that's good. I'll do the same thing to the other wire. Put these together like that. Grab my butt connector. Slip that on right there. Get my crimper. I crimped it really good. And I'm going to check it. Feels good. All right, now I'm going to take my little cover. The reason why I put the little cover is it then doesn't rattle and annoy you as you hear the thing rattling. If you hear like rock, 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 rock kind of sound, your capacitor is just loose and you just need to get it. Put this back in my container. Now I want to really pay attention here not to pinch any wires. You want to really get your wires all nice and tucked away. And then I'm going to put this back right here and screw this in. Start capacitors, they don't go often. The most common situation if you have a start capacitor go is either the motor's been run really for a long time and the capacitor just gets tired, or there's a problem in a new capacitor. And you know, when we do a unit, or in any company generally makes something, usually if they have good practices, they're gonna do what's called a smoke testing. It's basically test it, run it, make sure everything is good. Run it for long enough that, you know, you're gonna flush out any particular components that might be bad, but sometimes it does happen. Super easy, nothing to get stressed out about. You just put it on and you're good to go. We're all fixed. So there you go, there you have it, fixing a start capacitor. Any of you can do it. One of the cool things that I was actually told by my brother, he's a genius, is anything that you're worried about fixing, always tell yourself, it was made by mortals, it can probably be fixed by mortals. Even the most complex things, somebody made it and invented it, and with a combination of videos like ours, you know, networks of people that you can call, most things you can fix. More where we get stuck is we just don't have the confidence in knowing how to approach it. Certainly, we're here to help you at Highland Park Lapidary, anything that you're struggling with, and we help not only on our machines, but on all kinds of machines. We're all in the same industry together. So that should help you, though, if you got a motor capacitor. It's the same principle for any motor. Just three tools, a wire stripper, a crimper, and the screwdriver. Hey, thanks for watching today. If you like what you see, click the like button. Subscribe if you want to get more videos like this. And down below in the description, you'll find a link that goes to our website. It goes to also what we showed you today, more information about that. And leave comments. If there's things that you like, there's things that you want us to do more on, if there's videos that you want us to shoot that we haven't shot, we're very open to that. We're really looking for ways to help you be successful in your endeavors with the tools and technologies that we create, as well as any other aspect of the hobby.